family time with the tribe at the marina, San Leandro, California, enjoying the sunlight, the air, the sea, the planes, you know, the boats, the birds, you know.
Now, look how fun it is.
And just, you know, reverencing our Lord and Savior, you know, for giving us life, you know, for giving us gifts, for giving us chances. You know, forgiving us blessings, blessing us with every single, with every blessing in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And Christ strengthened us to do all things. That's Anaya, my niece. That's Trayvon, the quarterback. The quarterback. And he good at baseball and basketball and stuff too. Like me, all around star pro. That's the wifey. A real concrete cowgirl. She eats beef jerky and drinks Red Bull.
Just run that way. This way.
Might be having twins.
Nope.
I said cow, concrete cowgirl. That's, y'all don't know nothing about what that is. It's like saying, no, you can't tell the kids that, Quan. You know that Stalin song, huh, baby? J. Stalin. Dun, 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 dun. You know, when you bring somebody $500,000, $1 million every week, you know, a bond develops. That's what time it is.
So small today.
That's where opportunity would be. That's where the event that takes place. So yeah, I'm enjoying the time with the family, you know, the freedom. You know I gotta roll me one. You know I gotta roll me one and step out.
You know kids might be watching this.
I don't post my video for kids. This is strictly, I know they look, but I don't, cause I don't want nobody to be like, oh, he was exposing the kids, so whoop-de-whoop. No, I didn't make it for the kids, cause I want them to be, I want people to comment on my videos, but I don't get that many comments.
Because they don't watch.
No, the kids watch, cause y'all be watching. Somehow y'all get the phone and look up Uncle Videos, and I thank y'all for that. My other niece too, Jay, Josiah, Mariah. I'm not sure of Nakai. I try to get my other, y'all got more cousins, a lot of cousins, second cousins, distant cousins, great cousins, great great cousins, great 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 cousins.
What about Serenity?
Well, we heard from that manager of the Hicksville Trailer Park, Morgan Knight, on Monday, didn't we?
I'm not quite sure.
Sometimes I occasionally curse. I keep it real with y'all because, you know.
They're accusing Mr. Knight of testifying.
Y'all are exposed to a lot. Y'all in a world that's kind of like tough, you know. You don't want no more. Give it to Trey. Boot it. You hit.
You ain't gonna be able to say that. It's gonna melt.
It might stay cold for a little bit. But so by y'all being like they talk. They be blaspheming on TV with the cartoons now. They deal with witchcraft, sorcery, everything. Debauchery, lavishness. Am I saying it right? Lavishness or lavishness? How you say that? But anyway. Yeah, the seagulls. And the airplane's taking off. I like how the tide coming in. They ain't lying about the ocean levels going up. I'm reporting from California, West Coast. You feel me? That the sea on approximately the day after Tupac's birthday, June 7th, 2022, that the algae of the sea where the tide is a lot higher than what I used to see when I came by here. We've been coming by here for a long time, and it's solid green, meaning that's where the water's going, and it's higher than what I seen. Where the little boat ramp is, where you put the boat ramp in. So, you know, say in a decade or two, that's me expanding it. But for sure, in something later than that, a lot of stuff gonna be, you're gonna have to rebuild because a lot of stuff gonna be underwater. And yeah. Oh, you found me some shells. Thank you. Yeah.
Hey, look. They were right there where I was at.
That mean a bird found these or something and brought it up here, ate it. All right, that's cool. I put that up. Well, I gotta put it somewhere where I remember to bring it with me in my pocket. Yeah. So I tell them about Jesus a lot. I tell you about it every day. I bet you I got my Bible with me right now. I ain't got my Bible with me, baby. Baby, I got my Bible. I got a Bible, and it's my Bible. So I always has a Bible. That's why I rule with the Bible on the dash. And just because you said that, I'm about to hit you with a protection prayer right now. Even though I'd rather have it from the Holman Christian Stammen Bible, I'm going to bring it from this Gideon. Turn that down a little bit, baby. Turn that down. Listen closely to this, because I'm reading. And that's what you want to know how to do. This is the only book in the world you need to know how to read. But you best be reading it. T.T. would tell you. She has bought me over 50 books, but there is only one that I constantly read, and that is the Bible. I wouldn't have this marriage without this Bible. I wouldn't have my life without this Bible. I wouldn't have my sound mind without this Bible. I wouldn't have action, a future that I can hope in. So here I go. Psalms 91. A protection prayer, huh? Pee pee? Baby, do your thing. She need the pee pee on your side.
It is.
Oh, she gonna take it to the bathroom?
Take it to the party.
Why can't we just wash it?
He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide
in
the shadow of the Almighty.
You ain't gonna make it if you walk.
I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked, and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge. Ooh, they chopping it up. Because you have made the Lord because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge, who is your refuge, who is our refuge. No evil shall befall you. No evil shall be allowed to befall you. No plague come near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against the stone. You will tread upon the lion. You will tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray, man. Amen. I don't know. I knew when I was holding it was, but I was zoned out. It was a connection. Jesus' mighty, marvelous, magnificent, most majestic name, we pray, amen and amen. They say it's good for your eyes to behold light, but after you look at it, you be dazed for a minute. All good gifts come down from the Father of light, so that chip, you got that really from God. This ride to the marina, that's from God. That tablet, that's not for me, that's really from God. Your red hair, that makes you different, that's from God. Your talent, your abilities, your capabilities, your potential, you know, your gifts, your attributes, your characteristics. I'm going to hit you with 37 now. My mama like this one. This is a long one too. Let me get my breath. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Remember when you run it, in through the nose, out through the mouth. And when you a quarterback, I want to see you, when you get, you know, up and when you play for the foot high school and stuff, I want to see you as a quarterback run with the ball and then slide. Don't be sitting back there, you know, letting the people sack you and your line do that. Send your people out there running in the field and then act like you gonna go to the right and then take off to the left field without them and tell them to don't think about catching the ball. Block me because I'm gone. You got speed, bro. You can do that. I just thought about that. That's a little Madden with what I know, with what you know, and we gonna hit them with a spin. Fret not yourself because of evildoers. Be not envious of wrongdoers, for they will soon fade like the grass and wither like the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and befriend faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him and he will act. He will bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not yourself over the one who prospers in his way, over the man who carries out. Evil devices. Refrain from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not yourself, it tends only to evil. For the evildoers shall be cut off, but those who wait for the Lord shall inherit the land. In just a little while the wicked will be no more. Though you look carefully at his place, he will not be there. But the meek shall inherit the land and delight themselves in abundant peace. The wicked plots against the righteous and gnashes his teeth at him. But the Lord laughs at the wicked, for he sees that his day is coming. The wicked draw the sword and bend their bows to bring down the poor and needy, to slay those whose way is upright. Their sword shall enter their own heart, and their bow shall be broken. Better is the little that the righteous has than the abundance of many wicked. So don't be tripping that people got more stuff than you or nothing. Better is the little that the righteous has than the abundance of many wicked. I ain't got 1,000 cars or nothing like that or nothing like that. Fat houses or nothing yet, but I will, because God wants you to prosper. He delights in the prosperity of his servant. Don't let nobody tell you nothing wrong. He want to give you the desires of your heart. You know, he got good plans for you. You know, plans to prosper you, to give you a future and a hope. You know, not for disaster, you know. So, and he want to do exceedingly abundantly above all you ask or think of. All right. Better is the little that the righteous has than the abundance of many wicked. For the arms of the wicked shall be broken, but the Lord upholds the righteous. The Lord knows the days of the blameless, and their heritage will remain forever. They are not put to shame in evil times. In the days of famine, they have abundance. See? They have abundance. But the wicked will perish. The enemies of the Lord are like the glory of the pastures. They vanish like smoke. They vanish away. The wicked borrows but does not pay back, but the righteous is generous and gives. For those blessed by the Lord shall inherit the land, but those cursed by him shall be cut off. The steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be cast headlong, for the Lord upholds his hand. I have been young and now am old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken or his children begging for bread. You take it easy on this.
Give me a lighter. I'm just over here. No, give me the other.
I knew you wasn't going to want that big thing. I was just flossing. Like, now she want it. Give me my big thing. Give me that. You going to drop it. Give me that. He is ever lending generously, and his children become a blessing. Turn away from evil and do good, so shall you dwell forever. For the Lord loves justice. He will not forsake his saints. They are preserved forever, but the children of the wicked shall be cut off. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell upon it forever. The mouth of the righteous utters wisdom, and his tongue speaks justice. The law of his God is in his heart. His steps do not slip. The wicked watches over the righteous and seeks to put him to death. The Lord will not abandon him to his power or let him be condemned when he is brought to trial, when he is judged. Wait for the Lord and keep his way, and he will exalt you to inherit the land. Wait for the Lord. Wait, what is that? And delight in his. For you shall reap in Judah. Wait for the Lord and keep his way, and he will exalt you to inherit the land. You will look on when the wicked are cut off. I have seen a wicked, ruthless man spreading himself like a green laurel tree. But he passed away, and behold, he was no more. Though I saw him, he could not be found. Mark the blameless, and behold the upright, for there is a future for the man of peace, but transgressors shall be altogether destroyed. The future of the wicked shall be cut off. The salvation of the righteous is from the Lord. He is their stronghold in the time of trouble. The Lord helps them and delivers them. He delivers them from the wicked and saves them because they take refuge in him. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen. What you want, chips, soda, phone?
Soda.
I don't know if we got soda, bro. We got water. There's a water back there with you. There's a water right here. It's water in the trunk. We ain't got no soda. Yeah, no, it ain't no soda in the back. We forgot to get the soda. We got some chips for you. You want get the water out the back. You an athlete. You need water. As I go on to Psalms 34. She chilling by the boats. I'm talking about they just got a bench by the little docks. And I'm just sitting up here with a blanket over my legs with shorts on. Multiple colors on, you know, showing love from east to west, north to south. And it's keep going, so I'm going to keep it lit on the family day. I'm about to go chill with them in a little bit. Go. But I'm going to read this last one. Lisa, and then when I make another video, I'm going to read it from my Bible so you can see the difference. Psalms 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. Those who look to him are radiant and their faces shall never be ashamed. This poor man cried and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who takes refuge in him. Oh, fear the Lord, you his saints, for those who fear him have no lack. The young lions suffer want and hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. Come on, children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is there who desires life and loves many days that he may see good? Keep your tongue from evil and your lips. Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Turn away from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are toward the righteous and his ears toward their cry. The face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to cut off the memory of them from the earth. When the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushing spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. He keeps all his bones. Not one of them is broken. Affliction will slay the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be condemned. The Lord redeems the life of his servant. None of those who take refuge in him will be condemned. Thank you, in Jesus' mighty, magnificent, marvelous, most majestic name we pray. Amen, amen. Now I'm on with my little live stream, and I'm about to twist me something. Gotta put the twist. Keep you some chompers if you blow. Keep you, you know, sweet smelling fragrance like an offering. Like you can say that was a peace offering to God. I'm reading this word, teaching it to a younger generation, right? My little nephew want to learn how to read and be reading tight and be a real man and stuff. And I've been an influence, so I'm planting seeds of greatness. You know, we descended for greatness, so you got to plant seeds of greatness. with the words and still time energy. I'm about to go over there and see what they up to. But for right now, I'm rapping with y'all, you know. We vibing. You know what I'm saying? We tuning in. Oh, look, dog want to get in the car. Baby, she over here. You know, as I'm elaborating, thoughts and connections are collaborating, you know. Got Jesus on the main line advocating. Get over here. You ain't watching her, baby. Everybody's spaced out. I got that. Come on, you ready to get in? You ready to get in? Where's she going? Oh, she just running around. Come over here with that. I need this. We're getting low. Sun's getting low, Banner. Sun's getting low. Sun's getting low, Banner. Sun's getting low. See? Now, let me tune in. All right. Got this Red Bull right here. Little tree. It's a blessing. See? I got... You know, little pleasures, things, you know, keep me, you know, occupied, you know, comforts. Got to thank God for the Holy Spirit, the comforter. You know, no matter how pressed down, you know, I might be on every side, you know, and it's a trial by fire. I still found comfort and delight, you know, always had that attitude of gratitude because it determines the latitude that determines the altitude and the longitude, you feel me? Yeah. So here we go. So, you know, gotta have that list because I could easily drum up, you know, umpteenth reasons of why, you know, I should have a bad case of the efforts or something. But instead, you know, you gotta direct your mind. And I learned a lot of ways how you direct it is with your words. If you don't allow certain words to come in or entertain certain thoughts or put yourself certain places, then certain feelings or inclinations or anxieties or whatever you want to call them, notions or senses, premonitions, vicarious forethoughts or whatever you want to call them. Every place has its own, you know, should I say, spirits over it, you know, angels, spirits, or whatever. So I was like, I'm tired of just going from, you know, wherever I live to the work and to wherever the other family is. I was like, we need to switch it up and go to the marina. You know, it's a different feel over this city. San Leandro is the diversest, one of the diversest cities in America. And it's just real wholesome. It's welcoming. You know, they got the Bayfair Mall out here. They got Durant. You know, just if you just want to go and lollygag and just see some things, you know. They used to have a lot of other stuff out here. I don't know what else. They got a lot of restaurants if you just want to, you know, grab a bite to eat or have a little drink or something. A lot of haircut spots, a lot of, you know, beach shops, a lot of, I'm sure they got some hole-in-the-wall clothing stores. You got to hold up some pop-up. That's what I might have. Buy some material and just have a pop-up. Get the big sizes, get all sizes, and rent it off. Rent out a retail spot for certain days, and when the material gone, and judging on how good we do with the sale, we'll reinvest, get some more stuff, and do it all over again. Now, I can't even lean my seat back. Oh, my song going low, huh? Oh, no. All right, that's cool. We ain't stuck. I got to plug in. I don't want to lose your love. I don't want to lose it.
Before I let you go, can I get a little kiss tonight, baby?
Buddha.
Choo-choo.
There she go right there.